This is Information Service Engineering, lecture number 13, ISE Application 1. In this third part of the lecture, we want to deepen our knowledge in knowledge mining and information extraction. First of all, we want to define what is the process of knowledge mining, also referred to as knowledge discovery. Knowledge discovery, KDD, is the non-trivial process of identifying valid, novel, potentially useful, and ultimately understandable patterns in, of course, massive data sources. So there are a few words that need further explanation. Valid, what does it mean? Valid patterns. So to a certain degree, the discovered patterns should also hold for new, previously unseen problem instances. So they have to be valid. They have to be novel, at least to the system, and preferable to the user, of course. They have to be potentially useful, which means they should lead to some benefit to the user or the task at hand. And they should be ultimately understandable. So the end user should be able to interpret the patterns either immediately or after some post-processing. This is knowledge discovery. And we distinguish two different goals that might be there. First of all, we could explain things with knowledge discovery. This is descriptive modeling. This means we want to explain the characteristic and the behavior of the observed data. However, this is only a static description looking into the past. Sometimes we want to make predictions, and this is then predictive modeling, which means we want to predict the behavior of new data based on some model. Important here is, of course, that our extracted model or pattern does not have to apply in 100% of the cases, so it's only an approximation. It's a model, so it's not perfect, not necessarily. Okay, so let's have a look at the process workflow there for knowledge mining and knowledge discovery. We start out with the data. Of course, we do not need all of the data. We have to select our target data. This is the selection process. Select a relevant data set or focus on a subset of the data set, which means this is something we already did when we were looking for, you know, in the last section of the lecture, we were looking for female soccer players. And of course, we used Wikipedia or Wikidata as a source. And from that, of course, we have to filter out the data that we really need to get the target data. And then we also saw already in the data we have extracted there that there were some flaws, some noise. So we have to engage first pre-processing and cleaning tasks. So data integration from different sources might take place sometimes. And of course, data cleaning is one of the most important, tedious, and kind time-consuming processes of this entire knowledge mining process. Then probably you are not done at all with your data. You have to transform it, which means sometimes not all of the data is really useful. You have to select useful features for your further analysis. Sometimes these features have to be transformed in their dimension, or we have to reduce, you know, if there are vectors, we have to reduce the dimensionality to make sense with it and to cope with it, for example. So dimensionality reduction is also sometimes very important, especially if you are first dealing with, let's say, huge sparse vectors. You want to have smaller, denser vectors, for example. And then you do your data mining, which means you try to look for patterns that interest you. But you're not done after data mining. You have to explain these patterns, which means you evaluate the patterns based on the interestingness measures that you have defined. And you try to do a model validation based on the patterns you found there. So, and then it transforms into knowledge. So these are the single steps that you have to live through in knowledge discovery. Okay, let's focus on one of the main tasks there. I already mentioned it, data cleaning. So data cleaning is one of the most time consuming and sometimes also hard tasks you have to solve there, because your data is dirty by default most times. What you have there, you might have dummy values that make no sense. Sometimes data might be missing, so the absence of data is there, or you have data that contradicts each other. Of course, you have to clean it up. Usually you start with parsing, which means you locate and identify individual data elements in your raw data. So this is the first thing that you do. in times you or in times you are detecting errors, you have to correct them. So you correct your past individual data components using some sophisticated error correction mechanisms. Then, of course, correct data might not be sufficient. You have to normalize your data. So you have to apply data conversion routines to transform your data into a standard format. So don't compare, let's say, meters with feet and kilograms with pounds. So they have to be in the same unit of measurement, for example. This is data normalization in the end. And of course, if you're dealing with data coming from different sources or also within the same source, your data might occur on several places in several, let's say, tables, for example. You have to do a matching. So searching and matching records within and across data based on predefined rules is also part of data cleaning. And in the end, you have to put everything together in one representation. So this is then data consolidation, the last part of that data cleaning process. Okay, what purpose does now this data discovery or knowledge mining serve? Of course, you can do characterization, which means you might sum up general features of objects in a target class. So this is concept description, what you can do. You can also compare concepts. This is then discrimination, comparing general features of objects between a target class and a contrasting class. So this would be discrimination. You might study the frequency of items occurring together. So this is then associations you find out. You might predict some unknown or missing attribute values there. This is then a prediction class. You might organize your data into predefined classes based on attribute values in a supervised approach. That's classification. Or you simply do clustering, then unsupervised. So you organize your data, again, based on attribute values, not in predefined classes. So then you have a clustering. You might look at outliers, so identify and explain exceptions and potentially surprises in your data. That would be an outlier analysis. Or you want to find out about trends and deviations from that trend. That would be a time series analysis you can do on your data. All this is based or part of knowledge mining in the end, and might be an interesting task or functionality to perform on your data. We want to focus on classification, clustering, and prediction, of course, in that sense, when we are looking on our data and later on in the examples. Okay, so data analysis as a fundamental task within our knowledge discovery process means we want to find out more about our data. So this is fundamentally iterative. This means usually you have some kind of a query you want to answer with your data. You analyze the results of the data, and then you're going to reformulate your query. And then you have a consecutive query based on the achieved results. What you try to do with data analysis is you try to maximize your understanding, of course, of the analyzed data. You want to uncover hidden structures and patterns. So this is already really part of the data discovery process. And probably you want to extract what are the important variables there, so the decisive variables that really decide what is happening there. And you want to detect anomalies and outliers. You might have hypotheses that you want to test on the data. This is also another goal. And of course, you want to develop some kind of a simple model with which you can, in the end, probably then also try to make predictions. These are the data analysis tasks we will talk about also subsequently here in the lecture. Okay, but now let's get our hands dirty. And the first thing we have to do before we start to analyze the data is, of course, to get the data. So in the next section of the lecture, we will have a small hands-on data acquisition.